Hello friends, welcome back to the second video of unit number 5. In the last video, we have discussed about the different types of motion and also we have seen some important terms related to the study of analysis of moving bodies. Now, in today's video, we are studying the rectilinear motion. In that, mainly we solve some problems based on the uniform acceleration. As we have seen in the last video, whenever a motion of a particle in a straight line path, that type of motion we called it as a rectilinear motion. So in case of rectilinear motion, further for analysis or for determination of velocity, acceleration, displacement, distance traveled, by Newton's law the equations of kinematic motions are presented, which are very useful for the analysis of these moving bodies. Now in kinematics of rectilinear motion, we study first of all the uniform acceleration. Uniform acceleration, it means that along or during the traveling of or during the motion of a particle or of a body, the acceleration of the body will remain constant. Now, whenever the acceleration of a body remains constant, in that case, for analysis purpose, these equations of kinetic motions are used. There are three different kinematic equations which we have studied in the college level or some of the school level, which are like this: V equals to U plus AT, then V square is equals to U square plus twice of AS, then S is equals to UT plus half of AT square, where U and V are the initial and final velocities. The velocities of the particle or of the body when it starts the motion, that will be denoted by a symbol small u, which is called as an initial velocity. Then after reaching to the final point, whatever the velocity of the body, that will be denoted by a symbol v, which is called as a final velocity. A is the constant acceleration, t is the time interval required for traveling or for motion, then s is the displacement, or we can say change in position of a particle from its starting point to the end point. Now the sign conventions of these quantities, that will be depends on the positive or negative, depending on the motion of a body in the positive x direction or in the negative x direction. Now let's solve some of the problems for analysis or for studying the rectilinear motion of a body when the acceleration is constant. The first example is: a player in 100 meter race accelerates uniformly for the first 35 meter and then runs with a constant velocity. If the player time for 35 meter is 5.4 second, determine the time for the race. The total distance traveled is 100 meter. Now in this problem, it is said that a player will start from a point A. So here this is the initial position of the player in which he completes a total distance traveled or a total race of 100 meter, means it finally reaches to the point C. Now during the motion from point A to point C, it will be divided into two parts. That is, for the first 35 meter he accelerates uniformly, means up to point B, that is first 35 meter, a player accelerates uniformly, then runs with a constant velocity, means in first portion or in the first part, A to B acceleration is constant, and then from B to C its velocity is constant. Again, a time required for first 35 meter is given as 5.4 second, and we have to determine the time for the complete race. So here A is given as a constant, then S is equals to 35 meter, total for that 35 meter time interval is 5.4 second, and now if a total distance is 100 meter, the time interval required is to be determined. So using the kinematic equations, S is equals to UT plus half of AT square, when S is 35 meter, T is equals to 5.4 meter. Then also u is the initial velocity. As the player starts from the rest, it means the initial velocity of the player is equals to 0. So substituting the value, 35 is equals to 0 plus half of a into 5.4 square. Therefore a is determined as 2.4 meter per second square. Now next equation, v is equals to u plus at. So from a to b, velocity, initial final velocity will be velocity at point B, and initial velocity is velocity at point A. So here for A to B, V is equals to VB, U is equals to velocity at point A plus A into T. Now final velocity at point B is equals to initial velocity at A is 0 plus, now the acceleration is constant, which is determined as 2.4, so substituting it, 2.4 into 5.4 square, that is nothing but 12.96 meter per second. Now it is said that from B to point C, the velocity will remains constant. Therefore the time interval is equals to distance upon velocity. Now the distance remaining from B to C is 100 minus 35, and even that velocity is 12.96 meter per second. Therefore time interval t is equals to 5.015 second. Therefore the total ride time required to complete a race of 100 meter is, the initial time for 35 meter is 5.4 seconds, and the remaining distance time required is 5.015 seconds. So total time required is 10.415 seconds. So to complete a race of 100 meter, the player will take 10.415 seconds with a constant acceleration. Second example, a truck travels 220 meter in 10 seconds while being deaccelerated at a constant rate of 0.6 meter per second square. Determine its initial and final velocities. Now it is said that a truck is traveling, and the distance traveled or the displacement is given as 220 meters. So s is equals to 220 meter, and to complete 220 meter, the time interval required is 10 seconds. So t is equals to 10 seconds. Further, it is said that while being deaccelerated at a constant rate of 0.6 meter per second square, means a is equals to 0.6 meter per second square. Now as it is given deaccelerated, it means that a is negative. Whenever it is said that accelerated, the value or sign convention of acceleration is positive, but whenever it is said that deacceleration, it means acceleration is go on reducing, which is nothing but taken as a negative. So a is equals to minus 0.6 meter per second square. The negative sign is due to deacceleration, and we have to determine the initial and final velocities, means u equals to question mark and v equals to question mark. So again, as it is a rectilinear motion, using the equations of kinematic. Now whenever we want to solve such type of problems by using equations of kinematic, one suggestion is that initially you have to write down the given data as well as the required data. Then at one corner you can write down all the three equations. Now by looking after that, how much or whatever the data is given and whatever is to be determined, you can select the equation out of the three kinetic equations. Now here s is equals to ut plus half of at square. So s is given 220 meter, u is to be determined, time is 10 seconds, acceleration is minus 0.6, again time 10 square. So the initial velocity is 25 meter per second. Then the second equation, v is equals to u plus at. So v, the final velocity is equals to initial velocity is 25 meter per second plus acceleration is minus 0.6, then time is 10. So the velocity or the final velocity of the truck is 19 meter per second. It means that the truck start with a velocity of 25 meter per second, and due to deacceleration, its final velocity is 19 meter per second. And for within this, it will covers a distance of 220 meter in a time of 10 seconds. Now let's solve one more problem based on this. An airplane begins its takeoff run at A with zero velocity. It means the initial velocity of the aeroplane is zero and initial point is A, and a constant acceleration A. So A is equals to constant. Knowing that, it becomes airborne 30 seconds later at a point B. It means the aeroplane is in airborne, means it will take off in 30 seconds later at point B, and the distance AB is given as 2700 meter. Determine the acceleration and takeoff velocity. So here A is given constant, U is initial velocity, the time interval is given 30 seconds, and the distance is 2700 meter, and we have to determine the acceleration and the final velocity. So again, using the equations of kinematic motion, s is equals to ut plus half of at square. So initially s is equals to total distance is 3700, then initial velocity is 0 plus half of acceleration a into time interval is 30 square. So a is equals to 6 meter per second square. Then the second kinetic equation, V equals to u plus at. So v is the final velocity at point B, which is equals to initial velocity is 0 plus acceleration is determined 6 into 30. So v equals to 180 meter per second. So with a constant acceleration of 6 meter per second square, the aeroplane take off with a final velocity of 180 meter per second. Now the next problem. Two cars A and B accelerates from rest. The acceleration of car A is 1.3 meter per second square, and that of B is 1.6 meter per second square. So here car A and car B, two cars are given, both will be starting from rest, means initial velocity of car A as well as car B is equals to 0. Next point, it is given the acceleration of car A is 1.3 meter per second square. So acceleration of A is 1.3, then car B is 1.6. So AB is 1.6 meter per second square. If car B was originally 6 meter behind of A, how long it takes car B to overtake car A? Now we have to determine how much time it will take that car B will overtake car A. So here let's see it in this way. Here car A is here, this will be car B is here. So initial the distance between, it is said that car B is 6 meter behind the car A. So here car B is here, which is 6 meter behind of car A, which is clearly shown in this figure. That is, from here car A to car B, the distance is 6 meter. And we have to determine when the car B will overtake car A. So let's see, here a car A is traveling a distance SA. At this particular point, car B will be overtaking car A. So in that particular time, car A will travel a distance SA, and or the displacement of car is SA, and the displacement of car B is SB. So for that, for car A, SA is equals to UAT plus half of AAT square. So SA equals to initial velocity is 0. So here 0.65 T t square, substituting the value of a as 1.3 meter per second square. So sa equals to 0.65 t square. Similarly, for car b, sb equals to ubt plus half of ab t square. So sb equals to, again initial velocity 0, substituting the value of ab, that is 1.6 meter per second square, so 0.8 t square. So sb equals to 0.8 t square. Now from the figure we can say that sb is equals to sa plus 6 meter. Therefore, now substituting the values of sb as 0.8 t square, sa as 0.65 t square plus 6, and solving that equation we get t equals to 6.32 seconds. It means car b will overtake car a in a time interval of 6.32 seconds. Now here it is clearly seen that acceleration of car b is more as compared to acceleration of car a. It means the car b is overtaking car a. And by how much time, so it will be determined in this way by using these equations of kinematics, that is t is equals to 6.32 seconds. So in this way we can solve n number of problems by using the equations of kinematic equation. Whenever we are solving any type of problem, just first of all write down the given data, for which you have to read the statement of the problem carefully and note down whatever the data given. Similarly, wrote down whatever the things is to be determined, and then based on the given and required things, apply the suitable kinematic equation to get the required value. So in the next video we studied again the rectilinear motion for varying acceleration. In today's video we learned we discuss the rectilinear motion whenever the acceleration of the object or of the particle is a constant. Now when the acceleration is varying, how to analyze the motion, that we see in the next video. Till that, thank you so much.